Good morning to everyone. I'm Andreas, managing manager at Orfium. There was a point in my career that I have to be both an engineering manager and a product manager. I know this sounds tough, right? It wasn't by choice. I didn't choose it. But the thing is that the PM left the company. It was very difficult for me for 6 months to wear two hats, to have two different, totally different mindsets. So when the new PM arrived, it was at this moment that I realized that I have to put effort to cultivate this relationship. Why? Where's the next button? Okay. Why? Because product managers and engineering managers are in the heart of the modern software team setup. Basically, their relationship, basically we spin the wheels of the team and the company. We create a well-oiled team that can run fast and smooth. So we must take care of this bond in order to achieve a better impact. And this impact can be seen by the stakeholders and the customer. So that was my experience, and that's why I chose this topic to share to you today. So let's set up the stage. Let's define our roles. I saw earlier that almost the three quarters of this room are product managers. So what is a product manager? I think you know better than me, but let's define it. Product managers achieve business objective by defining the product strategies, and these products are technically feasible and there is a market to it. They are leaders. They inspire everyone in the process, from the UX designers to marketing to operators and the team. And it's interesting that they don't have direct reports. Technically speaking, directors and senior product manager have other product managers, but the product manager doesn't have any individual team member. So how many of you are engineering managers here? Okay. As expected, it's a product summit. So an engineering manager is many, many, many things, from system design to software architecture, writing code sometimes. But the most critical aspect of these roles, the most critical parts are two. First, it's people growth. They're preparing the next generation of software engineers and sometimes managers. And the other aspect is that they have to create a predictable software process and oversee the proper execution of the product. Is there anyone else in this room that has been both product managers? You are brave. No, I don't believe you. So what these roles do they have in common? They are very important roles, and what they want to achieve together. So they want to deliver high quality products on time. So the PM defines what are we building and why we should care. And the AM defines the technical decisions of how are we gonna build it and who will. There's a nice analogy at this point that I like to think that the PM holds the compass and the AM holds the map. At this point, these roles are complementary. But when it comes to the when we'll ship it, when we'll release it to production, then these roles are getting interconnected. Because although the timeline is owned by the engineering manager, there is the input of the product manager when we desire to release it. And there is basically a compromise at the end that it may affect what are the total features are that we're going to ship and what resources we need to allocate. Another common goal is that they both want to become great leaders. They want to create, to facilitate an environment that their team can thrive and succeed. We talked about the roles, we talked about their common goals. Let's define now why the strong collaboration, what the strong collaboration has to offer. It has to offer an open communication. They can speak freely to each other with honesty. They can challenge each other. And sometimes that may lead to better ideas, better outcomes. Because they know where they're heading, they define the metrics together, they define the North Star metrics, the KPIs, or everything else. Because they're totally aligned, they know where they're going, they pave the road. The most important thing is that they communicate as one voice to the team, and as one voice to the stakeholders or the customer. It's like parenting. They can argue in private, but never in front of the team. So, what happens, what the PM and the AM, what the product manager and the engineer manager are experiencing, it's passed along to the team. So that if the experience is healthy and strong, then the team will be high performance. A high performance team means that it's a team that's highly focused on their goals, they're motivated, and they can achieve superior outcomes. They are also totally aligned with the direction, and chances are that they're gonna get there twice as fast. Everything is clear to them. In my experience, a very clear description in a Jira ticket can save the partners and the team from hours of explaining the same thing again and again. Because of the strong bond, the partners can iterate quickly over prototypes and ideas, and that enables the team to deliver more MVPs, get feedback sooner, and test their ideas. And one last important is when the team feels supported and appreciated by two managers, they are most likely gonna take ownership of their work. And maybe make suggestions that the partners haven't heard or thought never. So, high performance teams are like utopia in our industry. If it would be so that easy, then I wouldn't be up here. So there are many challenges that can break the bond. The most common source of conflict is when the delivery time versus quality, the product manager states that we want to deliver as quick as possible and move on to another product or another set of features. The engineering manager, on the other hand, is responsible for keeping the morale of the team high and delivers a loaded product. Sometimes I find myself as an engineer manager that I have a totally different product from the business need. I think that my team and the code metrics are my product. And this creates an everyday conflict with my product manager. But we'll see how we can deal with this later. So another important conflict is that all items are zero priority. If everything is zero priority, then there's no prioritization at all. Most of times, the truth is that the stakeholders do not help to prioritize better, and everything seems that we have to deliver yesterday. Another source of conflict is that the responsibilities are not clear. Okay, we know who defines the what, why, how, who, but in the everyday, the partners have to take many decisions. Is it okay for the engineering manager to create a Jira ticket? Is it okay for the product manager to assign directly a ticket to a team member if the engineer manager is absent. Things like that that can drag down the partnership. Situations are not ideal. We live in an era, in the great resignation era. How can I be productive if I have a new partner every 6 months? Or if I am in a startup and the startup is in the hyper-growth phase and one day I have one team and the other day I have three teams, then I have to deal with more things and maybe I find myself to have three partners, three product managers or engineering managers. And lastly, last is that not all people get along. That's a fact. Even worse, we don't even choose our partner. So we need some luck with that. How to deal with the challenges? So let's see what values we have to follow. Trust. Trust is everything. Without trust, there is no procedure or a manager that can protect the partners. With enough trust, the partners can overcome almost every obstacle. Shared accountability. We succeed or fail as a unit. No hidden agendas, no backstabbing. At the end of the day, the company holds the partners accountable, holds both the partners accountable. Be nice. These roles are very demanding. There's a lot of pressure. You have to get in the shoes of your partner and be nice. Honesty. Be sincere. Communicate what you are thinking, even if it's difficult. And follow your promises. Keep your promises. And respect. Don't expect the team to respect you if you don't respect each other. Let's see now how, let's be more specific and how, what can we do in our day-to-day. Communicate as much as you can. This is the key. Keep, although the partners are speak to each other almost every day, daily rituals, meetings, okay. You have to keep, it's nice to have a private channel and exchange, share feedback at the first instant. It is nice also to have, to set aside 30 minutes or 45 minutes per week to catch up, know each other better. It's not only to discuss about work, but keeping a running agenda will help. And also you can discuss some problems you may have with the team. Use radical candor. Radical candor is the ability to give direct feedback, but at the same time show that you care. Basically, it's give the hard truth with empathy. Personally, I find this is the most useful for my improvement as a engineering manager. Share best practices. Ask, hey, what has worked well with you the last time you have worked with a PM or EM? And of course, be there to help the other who have extremely busy agendas. Should I have to remind you that the engineering managers have this period of time, the annual performance review, that they can't do anything else, it's okay for the other partner to step in and say, okay, I will help you facilitate this or that. What else you can do? Define the ownership areas. It seems obviously, but maybe there are some changes from product to product or company to company. It is super useful to have well-defined processes in place, although it's a company's decision, but if there is a product requirements document, this is a formal way to communicate the what and the why, then the engineering manager can challenge it in written form and discuss why the return on investment or the resource allocation doesn't add up. On the other hand, The team should deliver non-technical documentation with every feature, help the product manager to understand what exactly is going on the product without technical terminology, and document it as part of the onboarding process so the partners will know from day one what is expected from them. And the last part is be a great partner. So an EM should expect from a great PM to build a compelling roadmap so everyone is excited to work on, clarify the priorities and help the team stay focused, and of course, inspire. Bring out the best of your team, your EM, and everyone else. And on the other hand, a PM should expect from a great EM to deliver a predictable process. This is one of the most hardest things to achieve, but it is essential because in the long run, we have to ensure that we can have a steady flow of work. Another thing that a great EM should have is communicate in a clear way without technical mumbo jumbo. The EM should be able to explain why changing the color of this button will take 3 months or not. And of course, inspire, break out the best of your team, your PM, and everyone else. So, I hope I convinced you about putting effort in this relationship. It's too critical to be left in chance. The stakes are too high. But if there is one thing that I want you to remember, it's that you should have each other's backs no matter what. It will be a crime not to get along. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Andreas. Okay, I think I will cancel the paintball event for next week for the bonding.
Okay.
Okay, we have some questions here for you. We have some votes. If you have some more votes, I can go through them. So, first question, what if there is a tech lead also as a distinctive role from the EM and the team? What are the synergies among these roles?
Can you repeat the question?
Yes. What if there is a tech lead tech also lead? In the team? How do you distinguish and how you make synergies with these three roles, PM, EM, and tech lead?
Okay. That's a nice question. I mentioned that the EM is many, many things. It will help, extremely help. It will be extremely helpful if there is a separate tech lead role per product or per initiative. The EM should stay focused on people growth and laying out procedures. So if the EM has to do the tech lead, it means that it has to be aware of every technology, and it will keep the agenda too busy. So in Orfium, actually, we have separated these roles, and there is the engineering manager has the final decision of the tech decision, but there is a separate tech lead that assists per case. I hope I answered it.
All right, thank you very much. Next question, regarding the what we are going to build, you said that it's a matter of the PM. What if the EM brings ideas and prioritizes? How EM can bring ideas?
I think that the successful is that it's not only the what part, it's not only of the PMs, of the product manager, is for everyone. We want the team to participate, the EM to participate. We want this feedback. It's really, it's a tough job, maybe, and that's why it's so beautiful, but it sounds like an excuse to have one role to do everything. We have to inspire and we have to be all together in this. Maybe the final decision again is on the shoulders of the product manager, but is συλλογικό.
Collective.
Το καταλάβατε, ευτυχώς. It's a collective job. Do you have any other question?
I have one last question. I think we have one last question.
20 seconds.
It's plus, but it's okay.
Overtime.
Let's go. Do you have advice for PMs who want to avoid being seen as like the suit or the official for the team? Some of us are not technical aligned, as everyone might be.
Can you repeat it,
yes,
please?
Do you have advice for PMs who want advice to avoid being seen as the suit for engineering? Some have technical background, some not.
It will be helpful if the PM has a technical background, but it's not a blocking thing. You have to stay focused on the product, on the market. Maybe if you have a technical background, can't, I don't know, be able to clearly express in a more disciplined way what are you thinking, but I don't think that really matters. You have, if you want to be a tech guy or thinking like an engineer, I don't think that it will help you in the long run as a product manager.
Thank you very much.
That's my opinion. If you want to discuss more, I'm outside.
We have breaks, yes.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, Andrea.